Welcome to Unlimited Grace Academic Hub. As part of the topics under matter, I have explained the physical state of matter and the properties of matter. In this video, I will discuss the changes in matter. At the end of the explanation, the students must be able to list and explain the following: changes in matter, differences between changes in matter. Matter can transform from one state to another. For example, through change, ice block changes to water and water changes to steam. Likewise, the shiny surface of metal changes to form rust. So matter can transform from one form to another during changes. There are two types of changes: physical change and chemical change. I will use these two examples to explain both physical and chemical changes. Let us look at physical change. A physical change is a process in which a substance changes its physical form or appearance. As you can see, ice block changes to water and changes to steam. The second point is that a physical change is a process in which there is no change in chemical composition. As I explained in last video, that when each stage of this transformation is tested with litmus paper, the answer shows that each stage contains water, so there is no change in the chemical composition. The third point is that it's a process in which no new substance is formed, except that the water now exists as a solid, liquid, or gas. The next point is that a physical change is a process in which the chemical property does not change, that each stage contains water but in different states. The litmus paper test shows that each stage contains water, so the chemical property does not change. And the last one is that a physical change is irreversible in sense that the starting materials can be obtained. Let us look at this example to explain the reversible process of physical change. The last beaker with the vapor or steam must be covered in the laboratory, or else the steam will escape into the atmosphere because it is in a gaseous state. If that occurs, the process cannot be reversed. To explain the reversible process, when the temperature increases, the ice block changes to water and from water to steam. To be reversed, so when the temperature is reduced, the steam changes back to water, and when the water is returned to a low temperature environment like a fridge or freezer, the water changes back to ice block, which is the starting material. Hence, the physical change can be reversed. These are the simple statements that can be used to explain the physical change. Let us look at the following examples of physical changes: a mixture of salt and water, crushing of a can, boiling of a liquid, and melting of ice. Each of these examples does not create a new substance, as the starting materials remains as the final material. Let us now look at the chemical change. This is an example of a chemical change. When you look at this lantern, it changes to rust when exposed to the atmosphere. I will use this transformation to explain the chemical change. A chemical change is a process in which a substance changes or undergoes chemical decomposition. For example, when this lantern exposed to the atmosphere, the body of the lantern undergoes chemical decomposition to form rust from the silver coating. Another point is that a chemical change is a process in which a new substance is formed. As we can see, a new substance is formed, which is rust. The third point is that since a new substance is formed, the new substance will have a different chemical properties from the starting material. When the new substance is tested with chemical reagent, it will give a result different from the result of testing the starting material with a chemical reagent. The last statement is that it cannot be reversed, that is, it is irreversible. As I use the example of changes during ice block to water and water to steam. In this case, chemical change cannot be reversed. For example, rust formed when this lantern exposed to the atmosphere cannot be reversed to form the starting material. These are the few statements to explain a chemical change. Let us look at the following examples of chemical changes: burning of wood, rusting of iron, burning of paper, and rusting of metal. Each of these examples creates a new substance. As we can see, burning of wood will create charcoal, burning of paper leads to ash, and rusting of metal creates rust. That concludes the explanation of changes in matter. In this exercise, classify the following as a physical change or chemical change and give a reason for your answer. Also, in this question, state the differences between the physical change and chemical change. After you have tried the exercise on your own, you can check the solution on the platform. In summary, I have explained changes in matter, which includes physical change and chemical change. This concludes the first section about basic concepts about matter. In the next video, I will explain pure substances and mixture. See you in the next video. Bye for now.